Welcome to my channel. I'm Monica and I'm back with another video that I have every month. It's time for my October empties. It takes me a while to film because I have so many products in my empties and it's always a long video. Anyway, last month in October I finished a lot of project pens. So most of the products are from those projects. I will leave, as always, in the description box the time for each category in case if you wanna make this video shorter for you so you can watch only the makeup, the body, the skincare, hair, or whatever you would like. I would like to have you hear the whole video, but it's up to you. So thank you so much for stopping by. Now let's go ahead and start with makeup. So before showing you the products that I finished and I will replace, I want to mention that I don't have all the replacements with me because since my schedule changed, I'm doing my morning skincare and I put on my makeup when I'm at work. I know it sounds kind of weird, but I'm working in an assisted living facility. There it's only me, Colin, and our residents. And as soon as I can take a break, I'm doing my morning skincare routine and I put some makeup depending how the day is goes. Sometimes I have time for that, sometimes not quite. Anyway, if I do have time, usually my skincare goes around morning skincare, goes around 10 or 11, 1 p.m., who knows, depends how the day goes. And sometimes I'm wearing makeup, other times not quite. So that's why some of the replacements are there. I'm like living there because I'm there probably around 17 hours in a day. Sometimes less, sometimes more. But anyway, it's like my second home. So I will show you the products that I have with me. I have some of them with me, not all of them. This is gonna be for makeup and skincare. Anyway, let's go ahead and see what I have in the makeup empties. And as I told you, I closed two project pens as makeup in October. And the first thing that I want to show you are those eyeshadow primers. One of them is Kiss Ruby, I believe. I don't remember exactly the name that I had in 2020 project pen. Was considered a dupe for the Urban Decay original one. Was a good product. You still can find it on Amazon, although it was discontinued a long time ago. I'm not gonna buy it because I have the Urban Decay one, but I finished it and I'm glad to remove it. And then I have three of them from Emory that I have in my Graveyard project pen. Those are the Emory eyeshadow primer translucent, in the translucent color. I use them for my eyes and also for my face because they supposed to expire in December and January. I'm glad I removed them. Probably I had six of them in totals. I hope I'm not gonna find another one. And for that category as eyeshadow primer, I'm using right now an e.l.f. one, which doesn't have any name, but I still have the box. So I'm using this one. And let me actually put those in a bag because I have to take them with me. I have to take them in my bag. Then as I'm trying to group them in a way as concealers, I finished the Revlon Color Stay Under Eye Concealer in, and for dark circles I wish to tell you this one was a light pale. Is that air-free packaging that you twist and the product comes up. I did like the product, the color worked for me, so I enjoy using this one. And now I'm using this Tatcha. It's a color corrector in the lightest one as color. I have this one in my luxury project pen and I really love this product. So this is what I'm using right now. Then as foundations, I finished the Ulta Double Duty in Buff Beige. I had a whole bunch of them. I finished three in my Graveyard project pen and I am so proud of me. I never finished so many in such a short time, but I still have two or three of them that I'm planning to use next year in Project Pans. This one is the Double Duty Primer and Foundation. It was a little bit because I use so many light foundation lately. This one felt kind of rich for me, and I mixed the product with a light primer. So I use this one. I'm glad it's gone. And as foundation, I'm using right now the one that I have in Luxury Project Pan, and that one is the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I'm gonna use this one until the end of the year, and then I will have another project pen with a different item. I still have time to finish this one before May 31st, when that project will be closed. But is that one? And usually lately in the morning, I never use foundation at work, but I'm using BB creams, and I finished the Eau Claire BB Blur from La Roche-Posay, I believe. And this one is instant oil absorbing coverage cream mousse in a fair light. I like this product, but I would like to get something a little bit darker. I enjoy using it. If I will need a BB cream, I will considering buying this one in a different shade. It's exactly like they say, it's a mousse formula that blends very well. As coverage, I would say for my skin, it's light to medium. So, and I'm using right now, I have that at work, I'm using another BB cream with sunscreen. I'm going through my samples, so that's why I have so many minis. Also, I finished from Clarins in my project pen, I finished the bronzer that I had. And I'm really, really excited to remove this product. It's Bronzing Duo in 02 Medium. It took me almost the whole year. Actually, it took me probably 7 months or almost 8 to finish this one. And I'm glad I did. And I really like the colors. I repressed them and mixed the colors at some point, and it worked very well for me. Now, as bronzer, I'm using a whole bunch of them that I have in Project Pans. I finished also this Maybelline Master Contour Duo with a highlighter, a corrector, and a contouring. I like the product. I'm not gonna buy it again because I have a couple more contouring sticks, but I did enjoy using it, and I'm glad it's done. And I'm using one from what's the brand? Not Maybelline, something else that is just the contour, not the lighter part, but I like the lighter part to correct the contour. Then I finished two eyeshadows in my project pans. One of them is the MAC Naked Lunch eyeshadow, which I loved, loved, loved. I love the formula of this one. Such a gorgeous product. And I finished also the ColourPop in Special Delivery. Another one that is completely gone. So I'm very happy that I removed this year two full-size single eyeshadows, and I hope I will do the same next year. So far, 2020 was a great year for me as makeup. Now I'm using some singles that I have in Project Pans or in a Pendant palette. I finished this tiny guy, and this one is the Jane Ardell Just Kiss Lip and Cheek Stain, and I'm using them only for my lips. This was a baby pink, and I have another one like this empties in my October empties that was like a nude color, and I like that one better than this one. But finally, I removed all of them that I have. Still as lip products. In the project pen, I finished this very tiny lip liner, and this one was Nubby in something with pink. I had this one in the 50 Shades of Pink project pen, and here is what is left. I cannot use it anymore or sharpen it. This is the lid, so if I'll put this one in the lid, will be lost. So I'm proud to finish. This one was a full size, and now I'm not using any lip liner. I have to pick one from my collection. Also, I finished this three stick in Paris Pink mini lip glaze, which is this one, still from the project pen. And I have another one like this in the same shade open. I finished a full size lipstick from Burt's Bees, which I'm very proud of. And this one was the 501 Blush Basin, a color that I really loved. And I love the formula of those products. And on lip products, I have a whole bunch of them in project pens. And also, as a lip product, I finished the Clarins in 03 Red Berry, the Comfort Lip Oil. It took me forever to finish this item. I prefer deluxe samples, but I got another one like this in the calendars. I will use it, but I'm not gonna buy ever the full size, because in time the formula is changing. But other than that, you are always asking me what I have on my lips, because I used to wear this one alone and looks really beautiful, not to count the moisturizing part. So that one is gone. And I have a whole bunch of lip products in my bag that I'm using every day. Now I'm concentrating on my 50 Shades of Pink project pen to close. And the luxury one, because those are the single ones with makeup that I have open at this time. Now, as eye products, I finished this eyeliner still from a project pen, and this one was Soap and Glory Crazy Sexy Coal in the shade. I will leave the shade on the screen because I don't remember what shade of this was this one, and I cannot see the shade here. Or the print, it's too small for me to read it. But anyway, this was kind of like a brown shade. And I'm using right now the last one that I had, which is more like a blue purple. It's actually a blue one. So I will try to finish this one before the end of the year, but we'll see. Then I finished also, I have the L'Oreal Voluminous Base, the eyelash primer, which I told you I love. If you want the best volume for your lashes, this is the most affordable and the best product. Works so better, I would say, for volume than the Tarte or Lancôme one. But I love those two. Also, I will always buy them. But if you want the even more volume, the dramatic look, this one is probably the best. And I have backups. Right now I'm using one that I found in my collection from Wet n Wild Photo Focus Lash Primer. I don't even know for how long I have this one, but it works. Not as great as the L'Oreal one, but still does the job. So I'm working on that one at this moment. I finished this mascara from Maybelline, and this one was the Falsies Big Eyes, which I told you I love. Gives me so much length, so much curl, and color also, volume. You can find this one only on Amazon because it was discontinued. Comes with two ends. This is for upper lashes, and another small brush for lower lashes. As soon as I place an order on Amazon, I will get another one like this because it's a gorgeous mascara. Then, and as mascara right now, I'm working on the Lancôme, the Grandiose mascara that is a project pen. Still for eyes, I use this Mali eyeshadow, Evercolor shadow stick, extra velvet. In the shade Dusty Rose. The color was really nice, but the formula was I cannot show you. It's done. The color was very nice, but the formula was so heavy. I never use a product that has a formula like this. I have others from the brand, but they are way much better than this one. Anyway, this one is done, and I'm glad to remove it because I have a whole bunch of Mali eyeshadow sticks. And then the next thing that I finished for eyes is the Stila Glitter and Glow in Kitterna Karma. That was a project pen. I used this one to the last drop, and every time when you saw me wearing gold glitter was this one. Beautiful, looks amazing on the lids. And I'm using right now, because I just finished another mini in a project pen, and I was lying, I have another makeup project pen open, a third one that is a rolling one, but because I didn't use anything lately from that project, I completely forgot about. Anyway, I will close that one probably at the end of the year. I'm still working on some eyeshadows in that project. Anyway, as still a product, I got another one in an advent calendar that I will use when I'll pick up that product. And the last two products for eyes is this Benefit, the Precisely My Brow in a deluxe sample. It's completely gone, and I have at work the full size that I'm using. And also I finished this Ulta Sunday Fun Day, was a clear brow gel which doesn't look clear anymore, and that's the thing that I don't like about those products. I'm using now a whole bunch of those Benefit Gimme Brow in this size, because I have them from that I got them with points from Sephora, and I'm using those. And also I'm using, instead of the Ulta brow gel, I'm using the Anastasia one, still in a deluxe sample, because as I told you, I'm working on my small samples or ever from each category. So I'm using this one, and I like the packaging, because at least you don't see the mess that you'll get in your product after you use it a couple times. And believe me or not, I'm the one that I'm wiping the brush every time when I'm using it, but still it gets gross. So I'm using the Anastasia one. And also I finished two setting sprays. One of them, it's a mini, is from Liz Wattier, not so sure if I'm saying right, is the Magnifix, and it's a travel size, was good. And I think I have a full size from a beauty box anyway. And the second one that I finished is the Tarte Forest of the Seas, the 4-in-1 setting mist, which is this one. I have two more in my collection, that actually three. One is in my bag that I'm using, but probably I'm not gonna buy it again, because I will not need a setting spray anytime soon. And anyway, right now I'm using one that I have in the project, in the advent calendars review, and this one is the Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray, and I'm wearing this one now. Lovely, lovely product. And I have in this category also the nail polishes that I finished, because I saw that most of the YouTubers are putting them with the makeup. Of course, I didn't keep all of them. For the end of the year, I will have only the ones that I finished from October to December. Anyway, this one is a super nail treatment 3-in-1 with sunscreen from S&T. Lovely, lovely product. 10 benefits from this one. I would like to get this one, but probably I can't find it. I finished the Smith & Colt in mail order bride, which was a pink, and I'm very happy to remove this one. And also I finished this kit, which is from Kiss, Growth Breathable Manicure System. I'm using always a kind of a treatment product before application, and always when I'm taking breaks from nail polishes. And this one came with a base coat, a tint, and a top coat. So that's kind of all us makeup. Now let's go ahead and see the next category. As fragrance, I have couple deluxe samples and a couple samples, and I finished three deluxe samples, and those are from Tarte. Let's see if I can hold them. I finished those three. I got them in a deal with 5 for 25. I don't know what was in my mind to pay $5 for one of these. But anyway, the scent was nice and sweet. This one was the Tarte Sugar Spritz. Very nice scent, but it didn't last at all in me. But still, I enjoyed the... And probably I used the other two before, because I couldn't find them. Smells really nice, and especially it's a great product for summer. So I finished those. Then I try to find a bag to put them. I also finished the deluxe sample and a sample from Tova. They came in QVC. This one came in the QVC advent calendar, and this one probably in the QVC advent calendar from last year that I bought this year actually. And this one is Tova Signature Autumn, which was really, really nice. If I won't forget, I will leave the notes, and actually I have the notes in the advent calendars review for those products. If I will find them, I will leave the notes on the screen for each product. Anyway, I enjoyed the two of them and I finished them. Then I finished a vial from Nest. It's the Black Tulip one, another beautiful one that I have in a full size. And also the last two are from Gucci. I have the Gucci Bloom Acqua di Fiori and the Gucci Bloom, the original. The two of them are really, really nice. The more I use them, the more I like the Gucci perfumes. So this is all us fragrance. Now let's see what's next. As hair products, I finished a whole bunch of them in my 2020 hair products, hair project pen. And I have two products from Oribe, the jumbo sizes. It's the Oribe Dry Texturizing Spray and the Gold Lust Dry Shampoo. Love, love, love them. They are quite expensive. I will leave, of course, as always, on the screen the prices. This one works really, really nice. Smells well. There is no white cast, and the texturizer, it's a great product too. And I finished them. It took me almost 9 months to finish the two of them because I'm using more small sizes. And I am glad to have those two done. And also right now I'm working on a second pair like this that I have in luxury project pen, the same dry texturizing spray and the Gold Lust dry shampoo. Those are great products, so I always enjoy using them. Then I finished the Altena Caviar Anti-Aging Professional Sea Salt Spray and as hold it's one from 0 to 5. I love Altena products. It's a product that I use mostly in summer. Not something that it's a must in my routine, but I have them and I use them, and this one was pretty nice. I'm not using anything. Actually, I have from Cake a product in my 50 Shades of Pink that does the same thing, but I didn't use it yet. Then I finished this Aveda the Damage Remedy Daily Hair Repair that I told you. It works really well for me, and I don't have anything that at least not in this empty that I pair with this. I always buy this one when I see this one in FabFitFun or any other. And I bought a calendar, the ASOS calendar came with one of these. Right now I'm using the second one, and I think it's a product that really helps with your to treat your hair. So one is done, one it's in use. Then I finished, and if you saw my last empties video, probably you saw some pictures that I took with the products that I had in my shower. And I told you that I'm working until the end of the year to remove all those products from my shower, or at least how many I can. And so far I removed quite a bit of them. If I'll have time, I will count the products and I will tell you how much I had on the 1st October when I took the pictures, and how much I have now at the beginning of November. But so far I'm working on them. And this is one of them that I removed from my shower, is the Kenra Platinum Luxe One Leave-In Gold, which smells so, so great. It has such a pleasant scent, and was a nice product. It did what's supposed to do, let my skin, my hair very soft, detangle, and all the good qualities. I have many products from the brand in different sizes, so I'm not buying anything as hair, because I have 3 or 4 cubes, that the ones that are behind me only with hair products, so I don't have to buy anything. the single thing that I will buy, it's probably something that I would like to try. And I got some of them from FabFitFun, from Philip Kingsley. No, or not Philip Kingsley, I think was, or Christopher Robin. Anyway, one of them. Or this product, if I will see it. Also, if I will buy something as hair product, it has to be something that I tried before and I loved. Other than that, not quite. I'm using, as I told you, I'm trying to remove as many products I can from my collection. And actually all of us are working on them. Me, Colin, my daughter, and my son, when he comes, I'll feel big for him. Anyway, I use this one and I enjoy it. Then I have in here, still from the Project Pen, the Not Your Mother's Plump for Joy Thickening Hair Lifter. And you can use this one on dry hair or damp hair. I tried it both ways and I realized it works better on damp hair. It's not probably the best product as lifting and giving volume to your hair. There are other products that are working better, but I had this one in my collection. I used it and was okay. It wasn't a bad product. Then something that I will show you in my Ulta haul is the Naturalicious Heavenly Hydration Grapeseed Hair Mist, which smells divine. When Ulta had recently the 50% sale, I wanted to buy this one, but I couldn't find it in a full size. And I got the travel sizes with 50% off. It's such a great product, smells divine, and adds some hydration to your hair. Especially for me, works well because my hair is always dry and dull. So this is something that I will always buy. Another product that I enjoyed and I would like to buy, but I have other products to use first, is the Redken Freeze Dismist Instant Deflate Oiling Serum. Another product that smells wonderful and calms down my freezing hair and also adds a nice shine. So I would like to buy this one again. And the last two products that I finished are from Hesk, and those are the charcoal with citrus oil shampoo and conditioner. They work well, they smell really, really nice for a charcoal product. Nothing to complain about, but I'm not gonna buy it because, as I told you, I'm trying to not buy anything. It doesn't work, but at least I'm trying. I finished those two and I enjoy them. So this is kind of all us hair. Now let's go ahead and see the next category. So as skincare, I don't have all the replacements because I have some of them in my bag, but I still have a couple of them and I will mention what I'm using right now. I have the feeling that I'm missing some empties, but it's fine. We'll deal with this later. And the first two products that I have, I will start with cleansers. And I have the Simple Hydrating Cleansing Oil. I had this in a Project Pen. Not a favorite product. I'm not gonna buy it because it was very, very runny. And as soon you put this one on your palm, it will go through your fingers. It was okay as a product. I like the scent, but probably I'm not gonna buy it. And as replacement for this one, I'm using right now, I have in my shower, three of those from Kiehl's, which is the Midnight Remover, which works very well. It's still very light as formula, smells wonderful and, wonderful, and I love it. I have those in my skincare, rolling skincare project pen, and I'm still working on a whole bunch of Kiehl's products. So this is us oil or makeup remover. And I have, of course, in my shower a balm from pharmacy. And that's why I'm telling you that I have the feeling that I'm missing some products, because I know I finished more. But anyway, I have the Simple Micellar Cleansing Water with minerals and plant extracts. I like this one more than the oil. It was very gentle. I enjoy using it. It's a very effective product. And right now I'm using as my and also as micellar waters, I finished 3 deluxe samples from Garnier. And I have two of them, the one with the blue cap, which is the cleansing micellar water, all-in-one waterproof one, two of those. And also I have one with the red lid, and this one is all in one, remove makeup, cleansing and refreshes. I don't make a big difference between them, but if I will pick up, although I have all of them in full size, probably I will go with the red, the pink one. And as micellar water, and I have two more empties, two minis. As I told you, I'm cleaning my collection. And I have the Bioderma, the Sensibio pink and green. The pink one is the Sensibio solution micellar makeup remover. I want for sensitive skin, and the other one is the purifying one. One is Sensibio, the other one is Sebium. So I finished those two, and I'm as micellar water I'm using right now, one that I will review in the advent calendars this month, and is the L'Occitane. Was this one? It's 3-in-1 micellar water, so I'm using this one now for the review. Then, as still as cleanser, I use this Pond's, is the from Pond's, is the called the cream makeup remover. And you saw in my skin collection the big ones. I'm using the full size. I have two full sizes. Probably I'm not gonna buy it because I have other products in the same formula. But right now I'm using them and they work very well to remove makeup. Maybe at some point when I will be in search for a cream makeup remover, I will pick them again because they are more affordable and effective too. Then what else I have in here? Still as cleanser from my skincare project pan. I have the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cleanser, and I have two of them in a deluxe sample. Those are lasting so such a long time. And also I have one from the Calendula one, deep cleansing, which I love, love, love. The smell is wonderful, the scent is wonderful. I have three minis, and I'm using right now, I have couple minis in my bag and in my shower. I have this one, which is a bigger size, is the 2.5 ounce, the Ultra Facial Cleanser that I'm using. Then also I finished the Simple Water Boost Hydrating Gel Cream and the serum, the hydrating booster, which I like the two of them. I have a full review in the project pen, so I'm not gonna insist because this video is gonna be already long, but I would like to use the two of them again. They work very well for my oily skin. And as skincare products, I'm using now the products that I have from advent calendars because I picked up a ton of them, and I have each product in a skincare routine. So next, and that is us creams. Next, I have the Kane & Austin 10% Face and Body Retexture Scrub with 10% glycolic acid and 0.5% salicylic acid, which works wonderful. Almost the same price with the Dr. Lancer one, same effect, but this one is more gentle as a formula. I would love to buy this one when I'll be in need for a product like this, but I highly recommend this one. And then as a scrub, I'm using now from a project pen, I have four of these, the Lancôme Rose Sugar Scrub. Then the next product that I finished, I have in here some pads, and those are from Dr. Denise Skin Science Advanced Firming Facial Pads with Actizone Firming Factor. 100 pads in this one. It took me forever to finish this one. The scent is still strong, although it's empty. This one has such a strong scent when you open them. When I used the product first time, probably first month, my eyes were literally watering because this one is not, it's like What's the word for that? Not minty. I will leave that the word on the screen. The scent is so strong. It takes a while to evaporate because this one the pads were covered in that serum. I let the jar open so some of that scent to go away. I got this one in a pack of three, and I have one in my bathroom and the other one in my bag. I'm trying to use them. After a while, that mentholate, that was the word, the mentholate scent kind of fades, but it's still strong to the end. There is enough serum to last you a whole amount of time. Also, they are effective as retexturizing your skin, but it's not my favorite because of the strong scent. I'm using the last two that I have, but I'm not gonna buy it again. Also, from her, I'm using right now a serum, which is a favorite one, not the pads. I'm not saying that they are not good, but if you have sensitive skin and eyes, the mentholate, that very strong, will bother you. So for that reason, I'm not gonna buy them again. I'll use what I have. And as pads right now, I have to pick up something because I don't have anything open beside those. I'm using those when I remember to. But I have also, I wanted to pick also from my collection the First Aid Beauty Radiance ones that I like. So that's all as pads. As face cream also, I have this sample from Kiehl's that was in my project pen. It's the Ultra Facial Cream. And I have to say again that I loved each product alone that I use from Kiehl's. They are so effective. The texture is nice. It leaves your skin looking great, hydrated, moisturized. All the products that I use from each category were wonderful. It will take me forever to talk about each one of them, so that's why I'm cut that short and saying that I will use everything again, and I will love to. Then the next product in here, it's a lip scrub, and this one is from Beauty Tree. It's lip scrub in vanilla bean. I had a set of six probably, and I hope this is the last one. I didn't like it because the formula, it's kind of oily. First, it's kind of hard to work it on your lips, and second, it's even more harder to remove it. If you try to remove this one with water, it will take forever. You need a dry napkin or whatever, something dry to remove it and then cleanse, because it will leave such a gross film of an oily film. Not recommend this one. I'm not gonna buy it again. I'm glad it's gone. As exfoliating was okay, but when you try to remove it, good luck to you to take that out, to take it off from your lips. Also, I finished this Renu Skin, and this one is the Advanced Anti-Aging Lip and Eye Active Lift. Because I don't have an expiration date or a date when I bought this product, and I don't remember when this one came. I didn't use it for my eyes, I use it for my neck, and I always do with eye products that are either too big a size or I don't have an expiration date. Because I have very sensitive eyes, I am very careful with what I use. I prefer very tiny sizes like this one instead of a full size. But I use this one for my neck, and the formula was really nice. Also for eyes, I use the Benefit It's Potent Eye Cream, and I really enjoy this one. It worked very well on top of a serum that I finished, and was this one from Skin Iceland, one that I always buy when comes in sale, is the Brightening Eye Serum. I enjoyed the texture of this one, how my skin felt after I applied this eye cream. I also like it with different eye serums, and I used this one and also an oil serum, and it didn't ball up, moisturize well, and brightens. I have the full size, and I am enjoying the product. Then I finished this serum, and this one was the Skin Iceland Solution for Stress Skin, another great hydrating eye serum. You need only a very tiny drop for both eyes, brightens your skin and hydrates. And I have a whole bunch of backups for this one. I do recommend this one and I always buy it. And I think that's kind of all for eyes. Now let's see toners. As toners, I finished the Lancome one, and this one is the Tonic Comfort with acai, I believe acai honey. Is this one acacia honey, not acai. A lovely one that I had before in my empties, and I will have it because I have backups. Then another one that I loved is the LME Soothing Apricot Toner. Lovely, lovely one, but I love more the lavender one, but still both of them are great. I have the full size from the QVC Advent Calendar. Also as toners, I have this Skin Food Water Berry Toner, a mini one, and I'm using the Emotion right now that was a pair with this tiny one. Another one that I liked is the Etude House, is the AC line, I believe, and is this one. I would like to buy this one again, felt more like an Essence, great product. And right now, and also I finished this Alpha H Liquid Gold with Glycolic Acid in my project pen, and it's a product that I love, and I use multiple of this for to retexturize your skin, brightens. It's a product that it's effective after the first use, and I think the name it's well representing the product. It's from Alpha H. I think you can buy this one now in US. I'm not so sure. If not, you need to order this from UK. But great product. And as toners, right now I'm using the Ultra Facial Toner from Kiehl's in my project pen. And also, I have another mini one in my bag. When I'll finish this one, because that is gonna be soon, I will go with the Avène Gentle Toning Lotion. So, oops, that's as toners. Then I have also in here some mists, and I have the Caudalie, the Beauty Elixir. I told you that I have a couple of those. I had more than couples, but anyway, I'm using now another one like this that it's almost done. I'm using this one at night as a toner because it has a beautiful herbal scent. So I'm enjoying the ones that I have. Then I had in my bag the Georgette Clinger Lavender Facial Mist. This is really nice, but I love more the coconut one. And I have that one in a full size. And also I finished the Aveeno Thermal, the Thermal Spring Water. Many people are saying that this is just water, but believe me or not, my tap water doesn't feel as great as this one on my skin. I think I have another one, another mini one. If not, at some point I will buy another one because I really enjoy it. You know I love mists. Right now I'm using and I'm almost done with a Caudalie Beauty Elixir and a Saturday Skin one. So love this one. Also as skincare, I have the Say Shadow Cotton Pads. Is the facial cotton. You know them, 165 in this pack. I'm using them only for my eyes. And I found in my collection a CVS pack that are so similar with this one. Excuse me, the single difference is those from Say Shadow are a little bit thicker as layers, but they work the same. And I have backups of those. And also I finished the Beauty 360, the CVS one, the extra large premium cotton ovals to texture, soft and strong, that I love to use to remove my makeup. So this is us pads. And I have three makeup removing wipes. I'm using again wipes for my face, although I try to stay away from them. Right now in the morning, the single thing that I'm doing, I'm using a wipe to remove the creams that I have for last night. If I have time, I'll wash my face. If not, I'm using only one of these, and then when I have time, I'm doing my whole routine. So I finished the Tony Moly, the Peach Punch Cleansing Tissue. I had 8 of them in here. They smell so great. I got those in a Ulta free bag. If I will buy something as makeup or wipes, I will try to find this one because it's a really pleasant product. Smells exactly like peaches, natural scent, lovely, and also very gentle for my face. And two favorites of mine for a long time that I used to buy when I was more into wipes is the Simple Kind to Skin Cleansing, this one with 25, and the Neutrogena the Night Calming, that are my favorite from Neutrogena. Love the two of them. Probably I will buy them again at some point. Right now I have a whole bunch from Beauty Boxes and a whole bunch that I got from FabFitFun along the sales. So that's kind of all us skincare. Now let's go ahead and see the next category. So as body products, always Dr. Teals is here, and I have the Pure Epsom Salt Soaking Solution in the Shea Butter and Almond Oil to soften and moisturize. Love, love, love the product and the scent too. And right now, for this category, I don't have with me the replacements. I have only one. Anyway, because I'm using many products that I have in the Advent Calendars review, so you're gonna see them at the end of the month in the review and in my next empties. So far, I used this one, and now I'm using something from Couture. So I love this one, I always buy it, and I have some deluxe samples that I will use, and also the foaming bed. This one is a sleep bed with melatonin and essential oils, always in my shower. I'm using the last one right now. As soon as one of us will go at Walmart, we'll pick up more. Then I finished a shaving cream, and this one is Cremo Moisturizing Formula Shave Cream in Coconut Mango. The scent was gorgeous. I'm not the cream formula for a shaving product. It's not my favorite because I saw it's kind of clogging my razor. And at least this one didn't blend very well when I apply it on my skin. I heard great reviews for this one, but I prefer something else. And as replacement for this one, although I still have some creams from Wish, I didn't try them yet, but probably I'm not gonna buy that one. And you'll see in my haul a whole bunch of those that I bought. And this one is was in my shower for a while and doesn't look that great. Is the Three Hot Bear Moisturizing Shave Oil. Smells wonderful, smells divine, and leaves your skin so moisturized after you using this one. Looks like this, comes in a different scent. I couldn't find this one at Ulta, so I bought something else. When I got the order, I saw it's not the ones that I had in my shower, this one. And I will definitely look for this one. Enjoying this one. As I told you, it's very moisturizing and glides on very nice when you apply it. Then I finished some Lady Speak Stick, some deodorants, and I have a full size from Lady Speak Stick. Is the Invisible Dry, always use them. Was the Dare to Wear Black, works wonderful. And two deluxe samples from Native, is the Coconut and Vanilla, and the next one is the Lavender and Rose. I prefer those to the Schmidt's one. I like them better, they work better for me. I will look to buy the full size when I will need something like this. Right now I'm using a cream from a brand from UK that came in a calendar, and also I have the mini Schmidt's in my bag. Then as shower gels, I used this one time use from Sephora, from the Advent Calendars, is the Lagoon Body Wash, which was really, really nice, very creamy and creamy body wash. Very creamy and smells so wonderful. And I have another one in a different scent in my review for this month. I would like to buy this one, but you're not gonna find it in the Sephora in the US, but was a lovely product. Then I finished this one from the Body Shop, is the Peppermint Candy Cane, probably from last year or 2 years ago, I don't remember exactly which year, but was very nice and was a sweet scent in a travel size. Also from the advent calendars, I finished the rituals, ritual of karma, the shower gel which smells always great, that ritual. I have three, as I told you, I'm trying to remove everything that I have in my shower, and I have three of the Olay travel size, the cleansing infusion, hydrating glow body wash, which was also very nice and creamy. I don't recommend you to buy. I got them in boxes, but don't go and buy this size because this one it's almost, I believe it's $3 or more. And definitely buy a travel size set with different sizes like this and refill them with from a full size. To buy the travel size, it's way too expensive comparing with the price for the full size. And also as body wash, I finished this ritual of Ayurveda. Very, very nice. And another one was the Amsterdam collection, which was in the this year calendar. I got only one use from this one. I don't know why it was such a little product in this one, and I love it. I would like to buy another one in a full size. And I think that's kind of all the shower gels that I used. And also in here I have a shower oil from L'Occitane, is the Amande shower oil. I talked uncounted times about this product on my channel. It's lovely, lovely, lovely. I have backups in this size and a little bit bigger. When I'll finish the samples, I will buy definitely the full size. And also I finished the Amande milk concentrate, which I have again in this month review from the L'Occitane advent calendar. Lovely, lovely cream. This is so moisturizing and the scent, it's a wonderful, great product. Then I finished also two body scrubs from the body shop, is the coconut one. I had one in my collection, one came in the one of the calendars. They are more on the gentle side comparing with I have in my October empties, another one that I will talk about. Those are on the gentle side. It's creamy as formula, does the job and smells wonderful. Then I finished also a L'Occitane mini bar soap, and this one was the milk extra gentle soap. Really, really nice. Although I'm not into bar soaps, but I enjoyed that product. I finished also body oil, and this one is the Ahava Dead Sea Plants dry oil body mist with cactus and pink pepper, and I loved, loved, loved the scent. I realized in all the fragrances that are my favorites, the pink pepper, it's one of the top notes. So this comes with a spray, works well to apply it, it's moisturizing and smells divine. I have another one in a different scent that I will use. This is $42, so it's not quite the most affordable, but works wonderful. Right now I'm using one from Rituals, and I have two minis from Clarins from the calendars that I'm using. I will go with samples for a while. Then still from Rituals, I use the Ritual of Jing, and this one is the Deep Sleep Pillow Mist. As I told you in the advent calendars review, it didn't do much for me as helping with the sleep, but the scent was wonderful and relaxing. I'm not gonna buy it because I have a whole bunch of the This Works pillow spray. Then I finished two hand creams, and one was the Ahava mineral hand cream in Sunkist that smells wonderful, and the formula is very nice and moisturizing. And the second one is from the advent calendars and is the L'Occitane honey harvest hand cream. I'm using now a second one that I found in my collection, and I have it on my nightstand. Those are my favorites hand creams. I love, love, love them. I love the formula. I love the scent. They are very moisturizing and helps with dry skin. So I have a whole bunch of samples like this, and this is my favorite size for a hand cream. Anyway, two more products in here, not only two, couple more. I have two minis from the Sol de Janeiro, Sol de, whatever you call it, different pronunciation. It's the Brazilian Boom Boom Cream, lovely, lovely cream. and I'm using also the mist, and I have to tell you that my laundry basket always smells like this product because of the mist that I'm using on my clothes. So I will always enjoy them, and I have backups in different sizes. A product that I didn't like is the Vice, your favorite body butter that I had to use for my I use for my heels when I felt like my skin was drying. It's a Vaseline formula, and that's why it's that is the reason why I don't like the product. But if you have dry heels, it will help with that. And then I had the Ulta Soothing Lavender Bath Salts, which were okay. They came in a gift set from last year, and I still have some products from that that gift. Also, I have in here some bath bombs, and I have two of the Frizz and Bubble, the Spearmint Eucalyptus, two of them. Those were really, really nice. The scent was great, and they were very relaxing. And then I have two from Ulta, and those are the Rose All Day. Those were minis. Still nice, but I don't think I will buy them. I usually buy bed bombs from FabFitFun when they come, and I placed another huge order with the winter sale. That was crazy, but anyway. Another product that it's a skincare product for face that I use for a body, because when I opened this product, I didn't like it for my face. And this is Paula's Choice Sun Care. It's the sunscreen spray. I use this for my hands and my legs. I finished it, and I'm glad I use it in a way or another. Not gonna buy it. And also I have some products that Colleen used up. As I told you, we all are working on the products instead of buying something. I'm not saying I'm not buying, because I still buy a lot of products, but I'm trying to remove first the ones that I have already. I used this one couple times, and he used the rest of the product. It's the Suave Everlasting Sunshine. It's the body wash. I'm not gonna count those products that he finished in my total. I always will have there only the products that I use from the beginning to the end. So he finished this one, and I'm glad we removed this one from our shower. Also, he used the Ritual of Hammam, and this one is the foaming shower gel. And he uses right now another one from the advent calendars from this month, a deluxe sample. I tried this one before, and the scent, it's way too strong for me. And he's using those, I think those are from the men line, or I may be wrong, but I really, really enjoyed the body scrub in that scent. Then he finished the British Rose shower gel. I have a whole bunch of body shop products, and we're going through them. And the last two products that he finished are those two hand creams that I have from the last year, I believe, advent calendar. Is the Ritual of Dawa, the bringing peace and tranquility into your life. Night balm for the hands was a rich, very rich balm, and he used those. Probably he finished those, he used those in 1 month. To me, one of these will last more than a year, but his hands are like sandpaper. So he needs a lot of hand creams. He finished those too. Now he's using something different. And I have a full drawer with hand creams from beauty boxes. And that's kind of all for body products. Now let's go ahead and see what we have left as home products. So as home products and other products, in this category I will have some hand soaps. I don't have as many products as I usually have in this category, but I still moved half of my house at or can use some of them there. I will start with the hand soaps, and I have the Creamy Looks, which I told you before, it's my favorite formula from Bath & Body Works. This one was with Silk Protein, and it's called Seaside Citrus. And this one has, I have them for a year or two. I don't know if they still have this formula on their website. And let's see if I have some notes here. Doesn't look like soft, smooth, with silk protein, leaving hands feeling soft and smooth. Great formula. Then I have the pumpkin cupcake, which is this one. I still have some soaps from last year, and I didn't got anything this year. This one is with baked pumpkin, whipped vanilla frosting, and golden honey. Lovely, lovely scent. Then another one in here is the White Barn Give Thanks Gentle Foaming Hand Soap with Harvest Pumpkin, Spice Clove, and Sugar Cane. Another one that smells wonderful from the fall collection. The White Barn Eucalyptus Mint. This one I got by mistake. They sent me this one instead of another product. And this one was with fresh mint, crisp eucalyptus, and sweet clary sage. The print, it's always beautiful on them. Also, I finished the Rituals one, probably is the last one that I have from Ritual of Dao, a full size. They discontinued these Rituals. One from a haul that I forgot to post is the Stone Street Soap House. Hey Ho, wholesome hand wash in 250 mils. Those are quite expensive, even in sale. I think I have one or two more. I'm not so sure what's for Fabfitfun or BoxyCharm, either one of them, because that's the single way I'm buying right now from their sales. And I have two of the Endless Weekend in different formulas. I have the Creamy Luxe one, and this one is with Silk Protein, but I don't see any Summer Blooms, Blue Waters, and Sparkling Citrus. And I have the Gentle Foaming one in the same scent. So that's all as hand soaps. Also, I have those four candles from the Advent calendars, from the Ritual Advent calendars, which I told you the full size, it's wonderful, but those samples, not quite. I mean, they smell great when they are cold, but when you burn them, it's a different story. From Vaga, I have the. Those are the disposable lip ones that I'm using from lip glosses, because I don't like to use a lip gloss on top of a lipstick and then put back the wand in the lip gloss. It will get cloudy and nasty. And I'm buying those from Amazon. I think this one came with 200 of them. And I don't think I have another one here to show you how they look. I have a whole bunch of nail products in here. And actually, I do have, and they look like this. So are the disposable ones. I like to use them, as I told you, for lip glosses. When I use a lip gloss on top of a lipstick, they are around $6, and 200 of them will last you a long time. And I also use a lip brush that I always wash. And the last two products are for nails, and those are Le Mini Macaroni Gel and Nail Polish Remover, 10 single-use wraps. Was in the QVC Advent calendar for last year that I got this year, and they worked really, really nice. Although they were almost dry, they removed my nail polish in couple seconds. So I would like to buy those too, but I have something else right now to finish. And still, as a nail polish remover, I have the LA Colors, 32 of them in a peach scent. Those are nail pads, for nail polish remover pads, but they have some kind of like essential oils. They don't dry your nails when you use them. They are very moisturizing, and the scent is really, really pleasant. So I think that's kind of all for this month empties for October, I will try to find the prices for each product alone and leave it on the screen. I hope that helps. Let me know if the prices are helpful to decide you if you wanna try the product or not. So that's kind of all for now. I will see you guys with another video. Have a wonderful time. Bye bye.